Hey guys, so I wanted to talk to you about my weight loss and my weight loss journey and how much weight I have lost overall and just how I feel now and in comparison to how I felt when I was overweight. I've been seeing a lot of videos on what I miss about being plus size or what I don't miss about being plus size. I can honestly tell you that I don't miss anything about being plus size. When you're overweight, it is very uncomfortable. It's very uncomfortable. At least for me, it was very uncomfortable. I hated the way that my jeans fit. I hated the way that my shirts always fit. I remember when I. People treat you differently. They really do, especially when you're overweight. They really do treat you differently. I never wanted to be around kids when I was overweight because kids are very, very cruel. They do not understand, overweight and not being overweight. One kid I remember, I was sitting down at the dinner table next to her, and she poked my arm fat, and of course it jiggled, and she said, "Why does it do that?" And of course, I don't think she was trying to be malicious or mean. She just, of course, when you're heavy, you always take it in a way like, I want to pop that kid in the mouth or something like that. And you always kind of take it the wrong way, but I remember taking it so hard, and I started crying that day because it was awful, and that was not a good experience. Now kids, don't say anything. They look at me as normal. Adults look at me as normal, and now I've noticed that I've been getting hit on a lot more. And I don't mean to say that as like, oh, everyone wants me. I'm just saying that there have been a few times where guys do notice me. And before, guys would just turn the other way and not even acknowledge me. I'm gonna take my glasses off, see if that helps with the glare. Before, guys didn't even acknowledge me. They always kind of turn the other way. Now I get compliments from guys and, I get hit on from guys. And when you do lose weight, you kind of, for me anyway, I've never been a very confident person. I've never been like an outgoing, I've always been kind of shy. But I'm still shy. And so, like, when guys like me or they want to pursue something else, I always ask, in the back of my mind, like, why? Why don't they like me? There has to be a catch, and he's a stalker, he's weird, I don't know why he likes me. This is all just so new to me. I don't want anything to do with him. And it's not him, it's me. I know that I'm not used to all of this attention now because before when I was overweight, I didn't get any of that attention from guys or from anyone. So you will feel, even, I don't know, I hate it when people say, so you will feel this, so you will feel that. Because I'm not you, I don't know how you feel. But, for me, I felt very uncomfortable, and I still feel uncomfortable with compliments because I'm still in that heavy girl mindset where I still don't really like eating in public. I would just rather stay at home, eat by myself, because I still think that people are talking about me like, oh, look at her, she's trying to eat healthy. Or, oh, look at her, I bet, she'll finish the whole thing. I still forget that I'm not that plus size girl anymore. Because eating was something that I didn't like doing in public either. But then I would eat and I would forget about all the nasty comments, or all the nasty thoughts that I'm sure people, thought about me. So it's very different. It is very weird. I'm still getting used to being able to go into stores and fit into everything as well. I love the way that I feel in clothes now. I love the fact that I don't have to worry about going into a store and not being able to get it because it doesn't have my size. I'm able to walk better. I'm able to, running is still difficult. I'm not much of a runner. I've never been much of a runner. There was a video saying, someone was saying that she's never been an outdoorsy girl. She always said, I don't like this, I don't like that, I'm not into fashion, I'm not into this. And that's because she was plus size. And I kind of felt the same way. I was never an outdoorsy person. I never liked to, I was always at home. I confined myself to my room, I confined myself to my house. And now it's like, I don't want to be in the house anymore. I actually want to get up and go and have a productive day, go somewhere. I don't like being confined in my room anymore or just laying around in bed. Like, even when I'm sick, I hate laying around in bed because I feel like I'm back where I was when I was overweight because all I did was Netflix and, eat fast food or eat junk food in bed. I was always in my bed. I literally lived in my bed. Now, I try to do things. I try to keep active. I try to walk around the house, see what I can do, see what I can, like, clean and everything like that. I'm a much more cleaner person than I used to. I mean, I've always been clean. My room has never been messy, but I'm a lot more organized, I feel, as well, because I'm able to get up and, do stuff myself now. And I, when you are overweight, you kind of trick yourself into saying, I don't like fashion, I don't like makeup. I remember I was in a really bad makeup rut, when I was overweight. I didn't feel like I deserved it. I felt like, I'm just fat, I'm ugly, why should I put makeup on anyway? Like, no one's gonna notice me, no one's going to care. But now, like, that I'm, a lot healthier than I was, people do notice me, and even that is kind of like scary. Like, I don't know how I feel about, people noticing me and everything like that. But when you're overweight, you are. I was a lot more down on myself, and I would say I'm not gonna go clothes shopping because that's just another size that I'm gonna have to go up. I'm not gonna buy any more jeans because I don't want to feel uncomfortable in my jeans. I want to actually lose weight. I remember stepping on the scale and it was 224 pounds. That was the heaviest I've ever been in my entire life. And I'm 5 foot, not even 5 foot. So I'm short. So when I carry that much weight, it is very noticeable and it is very uncomfortable. And I was obese and I could hardly move around. I could hardly walk. I could hardly fit into chairs and such. Thankfully, I had never had that experience of buying an extra seat on the plane. I feel so bad for, people that do have to do that. But if you have lost the weight and you don't have to do that anymore, I'm so proud of you. And now you're on this new phase in your life to where you can travel and you can do more things with your family. I hated traveling and, I hated being outdoors and I hated doing all of the things that I knew that I loved doing. But being overweight definitely restricted me and it definitely put a toll in my body. I just did not want to do anything. And now, I want to go do stuff. I want to go see the world and I do want to travel a lot more with my family. And I'm just so grateful that I woke up one day. I literally don't know what woke me up, but I do remember looking in the mirror or looking at what I was doing or something. I was eating or drinking or whatever. But I was looking at what I was doing, and I think I told myself, if you continue this lifestyle, you're not going to have a full, healthy life. I was slowly killing myself without, I think I was realizing it because I was coming to, like I said, to the point where I didn't care. I literally do not care. I'm like, why, would I even start when it's going to take me so long? And what if this happens? What if that happens? And this whole thing has been just a complete waste. But then I stopped thinking about the what ifs and I just started doing it and I just started living in the moment and started living my life. And now I'm on this whole new phase of my life. And there are still some things that I do want to work on. Like I do have excess skin. I know a lot of people talk about that in their videos as well. And by the way, these are also thoughts, not from other people's videos, but you know, I am going through kind of the same thing that they're feeling as well. So I'm just kind of taking what they're saying and agreeing with them because I'm on the same boat. With excess skin, I don't like my excess skin, but I would rather have excess skin than go back to where I was before because I can still move around easily. I can breathe a lot more easily and I can tell. It's so weird because I stopped having sugar for about a year. I stopped drinking coffee for a whole year. I stopped eating fast food for, you know, an entire year in order to do this. And I'm not saying you have to do all that, you know, go to a doctor, figure out what's the right diet plan for you. But I did all of that. And now, like, when I taste fast food, I can taste how bad it is for you. Like, you know what I mean? I can kind of taste now, like, all of the horrible chemicals that are in that food. And I'm just like, oh my God, this is terrible. Like, I can't stand fast food. Like, Carl's Jr., Taco Bell, McDonald's. Like, I hate it now. Like, if I go and have a burger from Carl's Jr., I didn't like it. My mom and I, we went traveling, and we didn't have lunch. So we stopped at Carl's Jr. and I was like, all right, I'll just get like a small like chicken sandwich or something. I got a chicken sandwich, but it came back as like a burger and we didn't have anything else to eat. And I was like, I'll just try to take like one bite of it. I took one bite of it and I was like, nope, can't do it. It's disgusting. I hate it. I don't like anything fast food anymore. And with sugar, I will indulge in, you know, some sugar every once in a while. Now I'm not depriving myself of, you know, splurging. I don't want to say a cheat day because I feel like what a cheat day is when you stop all your dieting and you just binge eat all day. And I used to binge eat and, I don't binge eat anymore. So when I say splurging, I mean, I'll go to Starbucks and have like a frappuccino and that'll be it for the week or a few weeks, and then, you know, after a week or two I'll have one again. I don't constantly go to Starbucks and have a frappuccino or, you know, something sweet. I do know how to limit myself now, and I do know what my body can take and what my body can't take, whereas before I would just, you know, mindlessly eat. And I think I have really trained my body to kind of say, okay, you can't eat that. Or, okay, you can only have one. And then, you know, not have any more. So that's another thing that's different about me is my eating habits definitely have changed. I know it's healthy and I know it's not healthy now. Before, I didn't know what was healthy and not healthy. I mean, I knew, but like I said, I just wasn't in the right mindset to take on that step and try to make my life a healthy lifestyle. Excess skin. Excess skin, it does make me self-conscious about it because when I sit down, I don't like the look how I look when I sit down because I can feel all of my excess skin, and thankfully I don't have a lot of it to where it's completely noticeable, but I do have quite a bit of it, like my arms are one of the most I'll just show you. For example, these are my arms. I have a lot of excess skin on my arms from losing weight. And I know I can build some of that up with muscle, and that's another thing that I do want to work on, another journey that I kind of want to start. I do want to start doing more weights on my arms, and, you know, more the excess skin is on my legs as well, my thighs don't look as good. I hate my thighs and my legs, so I definitely do want to go to the gym and start, you know, doing squats or something for my legs, because the excess skin is definitely something that I do want to work on and kind of get under control. And I do have stretch marks, you know. I am not someone who can say, like, oh, I had a kid and, you know, so I have stretch marks and that's what that's from. Like, that, you know, no one says anything about that because you're a mom. Like, you're going to get stretch marks when you have a kid. But for us, when we have been fat, you know, our entire lives, or obese our entire lives, we're going to have excess skin. And that was something that I was a little bit nervous about when I started this journey. But, you know, now that I look at myself and my clothes and stuff, like, it really doesn't bother me. It just kind of bothers me when I sit down because, like, I can feel that roll over my jeans. It's not uncomfortable, but I know that there's a roll there over my jeans, and I just kind of feel like I'm overweight again, and it's not uncomfortable, but I just don't like it. I'm saying it's something I can live with, but it's definitely something that I want to work on. So I guess that's kind of what I'm saying, is that after losing weight, like, you're not, there's always going to be something that you want to fix about yourself. And, you know, you're never going to be 100% satisfied with your body. Like if I gain a pound for whatever, because my weight, it does fluctuate a lot. So that's why I do have to be very careful in what I eat. But, like, if I gain a pound or 2 pounds, I freak out about it. And my mom's like, Andrea, you're fine. Like, you're tiny. You know, you don't need to worry about gaining 2 pounds. But you're still really, really hard on yourself, you know, when you do gain weight and everything. So, food will always be my enemy. I will never have a good relationship with food. Everything that I eat, like, if I am on vacation and I indulge, I can't enjoy it. I have to sit there and say, like, I wonder how much weight I'm going to weigh tomorrow, or I wonder if this will make me gain weight. I'm pretty sure that I gained, like, 3 pounds from that meal. Like, oh my gosh, I just had, like, spaghetti. I'm pretty sure that I'm going to, you know, gain 4 pounds from that. You know, I always have to analyze things. Is that the right terms for it? I don't really know. So, and for me, like, I am a perfectionist. Like, I am a perfectionist. Like, being inside my head is not fun. So, any little mistake that I make about my dieting or my exercising, you know, I'm very, very hard on myself, and I just take things, I get so frustrated, and I get so, like, just, oh, why did that happen? Or why can't I stay at a certain weight, you know? But I am pretty happy at the weight that I am now. I just have to always be, in my mind, I always have to be careful. And that is one of the things that kind of suck after losing all the weight, because now you are constantly thinking about your weight and you're kind of obsessing over your weight. I was going to point on something else, but now I've totally lost track. But, yeah, I think the point of this video, like I said before, is that, you know, not everything is perfect when you lose weight. I know a lot of people think that, oh, my life would be so perfect if I just lost all of the weight. Your life will be a lot happier and a lot healthier and better, and you'll have less health problems. But will your life be perfect? No, because no one's life is ever perfect. So I hope that I helped, you know, some of you guys, if you are starting the journey, if you are already at your goal weight, you know, leave a comment down below and tell me, you know, what you guys did to lose weight, or what you're doing right now to lose weight. I want to talk to you guys, and I want to, you know, talk to people out there who are experiencing kind of the same doubts and fears and, insecurities that we do still have about our bodies. Because Lord knows I still have insecurities about my bodies even after losing, 117 pounds. But, that's something that I have to work on, and that's something that I need to work in myself. So I hope you guys got something out of this video. I don't know, leave a comment down below. Please give this video a thumbs up, and I will see you guys in the next one.